It's edition three of our conversation, a podcast with Eric Zorn and Mary Schmich, Tribune columnists. The date today is Tuesday, February 24th, and there they are, Eric Zorn and Mary Schmich, live and in the flesh. I'm John Williams from WGN Radio. Hi, guys.
Shut up and stop ranting, John.
Okay, well, that's one of the things I wanted to talk about.
I like how John has to check the paper. He holds the paper and he's like...
I also like the fact that he's doodled on the top of it. Is that what newspapers are for? A little respect.
I think that as long as somebody's using a paper newspaper, you should be happy about that. Eric, you're going to talk about saving the newspapers. I want to talk about the love of baseball. You want to talk about the Oscars. Let's get this Rick Santelli story out of the way. The CNBC reporter who said... on TV this past week that people who aren't paying their mortgages are losers, and everybody's been chiming in about it. He's been on our show a couple times. Why do you think we should start with this topic?
Just because it's the hot topic and because I wanted to say shut up and stop ranting.
That's your rant?
Yes.
She's tired of...
I'm tired of ranting.
Is it the volume or is it the message that bothers you?
It's both. We're just living in a world now of constant rant because everybody's got a megaphone. Whether you turn on the TV, you click on the comment boards, everybody is ranting now. It's become our mode of discourse, and I am extremely tired of it, John.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know what? It is actually true that rants cut through the clutter. And I'm reminded, remember that movie back in the 70s with I'm Mad as Hell and I'm Not Going to Take It Anymore? What was the title
Network.
Of that movie? Network, right.
Patty Chayefsky's Network.
And that, if you remember in that movie, the
Howard Beale.
Howard Beale, he gets everybody... in the country excited because he has this simple, angry, declarative statement.
Well, yeah. Excited and, or inflamed, there's a distinction.
Well, but he gets their attention. And I've certainly found in my career that the more declarative and emphatic a column is, the more response it gets, the more people get engaged with it one way or the other. And the more rabbinical you are, where you say, well, on the other hand, the less response that you get. So that we as a culture, we reward rants and we don't necessarily reward sort of thoughtful, on the one hand, on the other hand, discourse.
Do rants advance the conversation?
Sometimes I think they do. Sometimes I think they push the ball forward, yeah.
That's what Santelli was telling me. He said, well, because he and I disagreed and kind of strenuously the second time. And afterwards I said, hey, listen, I appreciate you coming on. And he said, no, anything that advances the discourse. And my point to him has sort of been that I think what ranting advances is the career of the ranter, that it got him on the Today Show the next day and more hits on MSN, on CNBC. So they all love it over there. It's good for their business. But I don't think it's actually good for the country to play on people's fears right now and to start screaming that this is bad when you aren't sure it's bad and when you don't have an alternative.
Well, and ranting advances ranting as a form of conversation, and I don't think that's particularly useful.
I also think when Howard Beale did it, that was a couple decades ago, and it was unique. Imagine somebody looking through on one of the three or four channels that you had and speaking to America and saying, I'm as mad as hell, and everybody throws up their windows and they agree. There's so many portals for information now that I understand why people are speaking louder, because it's more competitive. But I do think the clamor is greater, and it does get lost. There are diminishing returns on rants now.
Yeah, but on the other hand, again, when you want to take a topic and put it out there, the media culture doesn't tend to reward this, like I say, the thoughtful, balanced, nuanced argument. It tends to reward, tends to give attention to, and you see, it's not just this CNBC guy. It's been since Rush Limbaugh. Look at Limbaugh. Limbaugh, gives no quarter. Limbaugh has this straight point of view, and I'm not being qualitative about him. I'm just saying that this is what he does. He has a strong point of view. He advances it in a very, very strong way, and he gets a lot of audience. Whereas if you have someone who gives more of a thoughtful, calm approach and let's have all sides, let's talk about these issues, people don't like to listen to that as much, apparently. I mean, it's a sort of a marketplace situation.
Yeah, but I'm thinking of exceptions. I wonder if the pendulum, I hope the pendulum's swinging back a little bit. I mean, Larry King's a clown of sorts, but he doesn't scream. The Sunday morning show, Stephanopoulos, they don't scream, really.
You don't scream, and not to suck up to you, John, but one reason I like your show is that you can make strong points without ranting.
Milt Rosenberg doesn't scream here. Rachel Maddow, I don't think, is a screamer. And boy, she suddenly found a niche.
She really has. And Rachel Maddow is interesting because she maybe is a counter-argument to my point, which is that she has really gotten very popular in the last year and just by being really smart.
Well, maybe Go ahead,
and
Eric.
Calm.
I'll let you finish your point.
Her approach is often very calm.
Well, last thing I just want to say about this, Mary, you can chime in too, is that maybe I would be more sympathetic with the need to rant if I agreed with the rant. And in this case, I think that it's just opportunistic. And I understand there's two sides, and none of us, in the case of the economic stimulus bills, know exactly what's going to happen. So there should be reasonable debate on both sides. But I think that the people who are knocking it down have an easier pitch to hit, and that they are just happier for the attention they're getting than they are worried about the consequences of their words. And that's what bugs me about this.
Well, and ranters often don't have a clear solution.
Well, that's my
point.
They're
ranting against, but they're not proposing anything
for. It's easier to do. Number two, let's talk about Mary's love of the Oscars. Was it a great show this year or not?
I cut it off after Penelope Cruz's speech. It's not that I love the Oscars, but I wanted to talk about the fact that I was at the health club yesterday, and I overheard a woman there saying, you know, I'm just so sick of these Oscars going to the Academy awarding things for their own political agenda. So that she was saying she just wants to see Brad Pitt be named Best Actor. Come on, let's get real. Batman should be Best Picture.
Because it was the most popular movie.
Right, yeah. Right. That she's not interested in the Oscars because she feels that the movies that are selected, the actors that are awarded, are all part of some Hollywood agenda. You know, please, Sean Penn for playing a gay activist, please give it to Brad Pitt instead.
Yeah.
And I do think that one reason that the Oscars aren't as popular as they used to be is because a lot of Americans feel that way. I don't, but I understand that people do.
I don't know that we used to make movies like that. How many movies were there about gay activists in the 70s?
Right.
I mean, I understand that point, but it's funny because not many people went to see The Wrestler, for instance, and it was the celebrated movie, but y'all didn't see the movie, right?
Or The Reader, right?
Right, absolutely. They made a joke about it at the opening. And so is that a condemnation of the movie? Because the people who saw it tended to really, really like it. So, you know, I don't exactly understand the criticism of people of that movie, since really the people who did see it liked it. And the people who didn't see it don't literally know what they're talking about. Those were really good movies, right?
Well, I haven't seen them.
I mean, the question is whether, you know, these things, whether the Oscars reward artistic merit, whether they reward popularity, or whether they're all involved in this Hollywood social political milieu that people disdain. And you know, my sense is that yeah, it's probably. I mean, you look at those Best Actor nominations, right? I mean, all those performances, as far as I can tell, I didn't see those movies, but they all looked, from the clips, like they were extraordinary.
They were all good movies.
Extraordinarily well done.
They were.
And so how do you even compare those things? So that in a sense it does become involved in other issues, in other, you know, sending other messages about, and you know, the idea of politicization of the Oscars, I mean, it goes way back, doesn't it? I mean, to Marlon Brando and those in the Coming Home and the movies that are rewarded back when, because they all had messages that people liked rather than Philadelphia.
But, you know, there is something annoying to me, even though a lot of the Hollywood agenda would be my political agenda. There is something annoying to me about feeling that these actors are getting up and saying, hey, look at me. Look at my fabulous $100,000 gown. And now I'm going to preach to you about politics.
You know, I had the same thought when Sean Penn got up and gave his speech, which you were, I guess, sleeping at that point. Did you hear about it, though? He got up
No.
and said, he said that our grandchildren or whatever will be ashamed at us for not endorsing gay marriage. And I happen to believe in that absolutely. I think that it is a shame that that gay marriage isn't legal. But on the other hand, I cringed when he was giving that speech. I'm thinking, how is this playing in middle America? How would I feel if he were up there saying the opposite? I mean, it's fine to sit there and cheer him on and go, yeah, it's Sean. But is this really the place for it? Does this really advance the ball to do that? And how does it feel to people who are watching it?
I thought you guys were more interested in the television show itself, the Oscars. These points notwithstanding, I thought it was a pretty good show. I didn't stay awake for all of it. But what I saw was really good. And some of the reviews I heard, Steve Cochran, my colleague here, and he and I don't always see eye to eye, he thought it was a fabulous show. I like the fact, I wish they would maybe mix the political message, But I think especially now, we need some beautiful people to just show us their beauty and show us beautiful clips of their beautiful movies and sort of take us away from it all. I thought it was the right show at the right time.
It was interesting, though, that they had Hugh Jackman MC and they didn't bring a comedian on who was going to make fun of Hollywood.
Oh, you think that was protecting them?
Oh, yes, absolutely. That this was not the year that they wanted Billy Crystal or who have been the other notorious Hollywood dissers who have stood up and made fun of the whole spectacle.